हेलो, दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर सोशल साइंस सब्जेक्ट ज्योग्राफी पोर्शन. फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज़ रिसोर्सेज. नाउ हियर वी लर्न अबाउट रिसोर्सेज एंड टाइप्स ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. सी, मोना एंड राजू दे वर हेल्पिंग देयर मदर टू क्लीन द हाउस. दे वर टॉकिंग अबाउट सम थिंग्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्लोथ्स, यूटेंसिल, फूड ग्रेन्स, कॉम्ब्स एट्सेट्रा. दीज ऑल आर थिंग्स एंड वी यूज देम, said Mona. Now they are important. Now mother is telling that all these things we are using are important and these are resources. Now what is a resource? That was question of Raju. Anything that can be used to satisfy a need is a resource, replied Amma. Look around you and observe. You will be able to identify many types of resources. If we look around us, we can see many kinds of resources that are useful to us. For example, if we are thirsty, we drink water. We use electricity in a house, rickshaws to go to school, market or any other places. We use textbook to study. All these are resources. Even if your father is preparing a snack for you, fresh vegetables available, all this has a use and they are known as a resource. Now water, electricity, rickshaw, vegetable and textbook have something in common. That is its utility. Means all these things are used. Ye hum use karte hai. So they are known as utility. Utility or usability is what makes an object or substance or resources. Ye jo wo cheez hai jo utility object ke use hum jo karte hai usko. Use hum kehte hai resource. Isi utility ko wohi resource banate hai. Now how does something become a resource? Now Raju is asking के कोई भी चीज़ है वो resource कैसे बनती है. Amma told the children that things become resources only when they have a value. If anything is having a value, then it is known as a resource. Okay? If it has a worth. For example, metals. See, some will be having economical value and some won't be having economic value. For example, if we talk about metals, gold, silver, they have economical value. They are a resource which are available to us. Okay, so they are having economical value. And if we talk about beautiful landscape, for example, mountain or rivers, anything else, they don't have any economical value. But see, both these things, economic value if they are having or they are not having. Both these things are very important and they satisfy human needs. They satisfy all our needs. Some resources can become economically valuable with time. As time passes, we can use these resources and these resources can be considered as economically valuable. Means it has some price value. If, for example, you can see if your grandmother has made some home remedies, you know that our grandmothers give us some home remedies. They don't have commercial value, but if it is patented and sold by a medical firm, for example, a medical firm is preparing those things using those remedies, then it would have some economic value you will be having of those objects. Time and technology are two important factors that can change substances into resources. Both are related to the needs of the people. People themselves are the most important resources. It is their ideas, knowledge, invention and discoveries that lead to the creation of more resources. See, we can see that time and technology, both are important factors. Time, you know, technology is the skill, the latest knowledge we are using to make something and that we are using to change some substances into resources. Both are related to the needs of the people. Now see, people themselves are the most important resources. They are people themselves are the resources. Why they are resources, we can tell. It is their ideas, knowledge, invention and discoveries that lead to the creation of more resources. We can see that these have ideas, knowledge and inventions and discoveries. People use all these things. So these leads to creation of more resources. More resources can be developed using this. So each discovery of invention leads to many others. One discovery will lead to many more inventions if they are discovering anything new. The discovery of fire. We can talk about fire that led to the practice of cooking. See, earlier people, they were not cooking the food because fire was not invented. As they invented fire, they started cooking food. Means there was something new, invention took place after that discovery. Same way we can talk about wheel. As wheel was invented, then as time passed, there was development in new modes of transport. New transportation facilities are available nowadays. You can see that how that invention continued and it renovated and it invented new things in that. The technology to create hydroelectricity has turned energy in fast flowing water into an important resource. See, you know about hydroelectricity that converts energy from flowing water. So we can use electricity. So that is also one kind of technology we are using and we are inventing to make our life more easy. And that is also known as resources. Now we'll learn about types of resources. There are three types of resources, that is natural, human made and human. Now first we'll talk about natural resources. Natural resources are those resources which we get it from nature and we can use it as it is without modifying it, and that is known as natural resource. The air we breathe, the water in our rivers and lakes, the soils, minerals are all natural resources. Many of these resources are free gifts of nature and can be used directly. See, they are gift of nature, so we can use it directly. In some cases and technology, tools and technology may be needed to use a natural resource in the best possible way. See, some natural resources are those that we need tools and technology to convert those natural resources so that we can use it easily. Natural resources can be categorized into two resources, that is renewable and non-renewable. Now we'll learn about renewable and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those which get renewed or replenished quickly. Some of these are unlimited and are not affected by human activities such as solar and wind energy. Those resources which we can renew it, okay, that is known as renewable resources, and they are unlimited, but and they are also not affected by human activities. We can talk about solar energy and wind energy. Yet careless use of certain renewable resources like water, soil and forest can affect their stock. See, some like water, soil, if you are not using it carefully, okay, if you are careless against those resources, then they will affect their stock. Water seems to be an unlimited renewable resources, but shortage and drying up of natural water resources is a major problem in many parts of the world today. See, you can see that today, nowadays, even there is a scarcity of water as it is available in plenty, that is 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water, then too there is shortage of water. So we can see that we have to use all these resources carefully. Now we'll talk about non-renewable resources. These resources are those which have a limited stock. Ek limited stock hota hai unka, and they can be that these stocks are exhausted. It may take thousands of years to be renewed or replenished. ये जो stocks है वो exhaust हो सकते हैं, मतलब खत्म हो सकते हैं, और इन्हें नया बनने में thousands of years लगते हैं. And that is more than our human lifespan. मतलब हमारी जो life होती है, it takes more than that time to be renewed. So they are known as non-renewable resources. Such resources are considered non-renewable. Coal, petroleum and natural gas are some examples. Now see, distribution of natural resource depends upon number of physical factors like terrain, climate and altitude. All these things shows the distribution of natural resources and it is dependent on these factors. The distribution of resources is unequal because these factors differ so much over the earth. See, on the earth it varies if we talk about the places on the earth, these factors are different in different region. So there is a difference in distribution of natural resources in these places. Now we'll talk about human made resources. Sometimes natural substances become resources only when their original form has been changed. See, some substances, natural substances, we have to change their original form so that we can use it. For example, iron ore, that was not a resource until people learned to extract iron. See, as people started learning and how to extract iron from it, they used those, they converted the natural resource into, they've changed it using tools and technology. And nowadays, these irons, for example, are used in buildings, bridges, roads, machinery and vehicles. So we can say that these are human made resources. So technology is also a human made resource. Technology is also made by human, and so people like us use natural resource to make human made resources. So using these natural resource when converted into a form so that we can use it as a resource, then those resources are known as human made resource. Now we'll talk about human resource. People can make the best use of nature to create more resources. See, people, they are very knowledgeable, means they have skills also, so they can create more resources using this available resources, using the technology, the ideas and knowledge, etc. So humans are special resource and people are human resource only. Education and health help in making people a valuable resource. Education jo hai और हेल्थ वो दे हेल्प पीपल टू मेक अ वैल्यूएबल रिसोर्स, एक वैल्यूएबल रिसोर्स वो बना सकते हैं. नाउ व्हाट इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट? व्हाट इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट? इम्प्रूविंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ पीपल्स स्किल, लोगों की क्वालिटी को इम्प्रूव करना, उनकी स्किल को, सो दैट दे आर एबल टू क्रिएट मोर रिसोर्सेज, ताकि वो नए रिसोर्सेज क्रिएट कर सके. दैट इज नोन एज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट. नाउ वी लर्न हाउ टू कंजर्व रिसोर्सेज. सी, कंजर्वेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज इज वेरी नेसेसरी बिकॉज द स्केयरसिटी विल नॉट बी अफोर्डेड. सी, वंस मोना गॉट अ नाइटमेयर दैट शी ड्रीम्ड दैट देर वॉज नो वाटर ऑन द अर्थ, एवरीथिंग वॉज ड्राइड अप, trees were cut down, people were suffering and they were roaming here and there desperately looking for food and shade, just they were roaming here and there. So she told about this dream to her mother. Now mother replied that if we do not use these resources carefully, then renewable resources can become very scarce. Means jo renewable resources hai, for example water, if you are not using it properly, then there will be a scarcity of water and the non-renewable ones can definitely get exhausted, and the non-renewable resources, they will to get exhausted only, we will not get those resources. What can we do about it? Now Raju asked. Using resources carefully and giving them time to get renewed is called resource conservation. Now what is resource conservation? That we are using resources carefully and we are giving them time to get renewed. Hum unhe time de rahe renew karne ke liye and wo resources hum carefully use kar rahe hai, to hum use kehte hai resource conservation. And balancing the need to use resources and also to conserve them for the future is called sustainable development. If we are using the resources properly and we are also conserving it for future, then it is known as sustainable development. So there are many ways to conserve resources. See, this children, they decided how they will save resources. They are deciding how they will save resources. For example, Jessie, that she will use paper carefully, as papers are made from trees. So if more papers will be wasted, more trees will be cut to make paper. So she said that she will use it carefully. Then Mustafa is telling that electricity should not be wasted, as water and coal is used to generate electricity. Then Asha is telling that she is not going to waste water, as water is very precious and there won't be water if they are using like this. So every drop of water is precious to all of us. And this way they are deciding how they are going to conserve the resources. Now you also have to write down that how you are going to help in conserving resources. You can write at least 5 points in your notebook and see some principles are given of sustainable development. You can read this and you can follow so that we can conserve resources and there is a sustainable development for the resources. Thank you.